clock.
Continuing to see in the sinkhole. Local
Heiser warning still in effect.
7 days a week until 10 a.m.
Don't checking out the damage left behind.
Mornings on 2 on Fox 2.
Never touch a down power line. Assume they are live and dangerous. If you see a down line, stay away. Call 911 and avoid touching anything that has come into contact with the power line.
The 49ers say hello again and welcome back. Debo Samuel, the Cardinals, and the NFL say goodbye to three-time Defensive Player of the Year, J.J. Watt. Close out the regular season today, hosting the Arizona Cardinals. 49ers with a lot at stake here. A chance to be the number one seed in the NFC playoffs. Currently, they're at 3. They need a win and an Eagle loss to get the top spot, but they also need a win to secure the 2 seed in the playoffs. With all from running back Robert Smith, I'm Chris Myers. And thanks for being with us, man. The 49ers are hot, going for their 10th straight top-ranked defense and a 7th-round rookie quarterback. Last guy in the draft. Head-turning performance from Brock Purdy. And as young as he is, has a few more toys to play with in this final tune-up before the playoffs.
Yeah, it's great to have Debo back. It's great to have Elijah Mitchell back in this one. You always want to play your best football heading into the playoffs. Of course, you still have that chance at that number one seed. But it's especially important for Brock Purdy get that extra time with those players, because there's nothing like live game wins.
And the Cardinals will bring it, but they're a mess. There's 6 straight losses here. They're trying to organize. David Blau has started last week. He's the 4th different quarterback starting for the Cardinals this season. But they do have J.J. Watt, one of the greatest defensive players in the modern era, and he will play his final game today.
Yeah, and he's been the model for work ethic throughout his career, and I'm sure in his time with the Cardinals. But he's also been